Simon says subscribe and click on the bell icon to receive notifications.
Let's just first take a look at what the taskbar looks like here in Windows 11, just so we can understand what's new in Windows 11 compared to previous operating systems. Well, if we take a look, first of all, you'll notice that my taskbar automatically comes up in the middle with my Windows logo right there, and then a few other features here to follow it. But let's go ahead and start over here on the left-hand side. This is known as my widgets icon there. If I click on that, a whole bunch of things are going to come up here. We're going to talk about that in a future lesson in terms of how to modify and customize this. I'm going to go ahead and click away. Now you'll notice over here I have my Windows icon there, and that's going to go ahead and take me to my start menu. And then following that, I have the ability to search, and then also I have the ability to search with AI with Microsoft's new Bing AI features. Now you'll also see here that I have the option to go to different task views. One of those tasks you might want to do is working with additional desktops, which we're going to talk about later on. And also, if I click on it, you'll see here I have all my open windows that I can go ahead and toggle between. I'm going to go ahead and click away. And then following that, I have the ability to do different types of chat, which is basically a light version of Microsoft Teams if you want to chat with other people who are on Windows 11 and within your team. Now, to the right-hand side, you'll see a bunch of icons here that I've saved to my taskbar. And you'll also notice that below the ones that are open, you'll see is a little dot. Okay, and now this one is not open and these are open. But I may not like what I see here. Now, I'm going to go ahead and right-click on that, and I'm going to choose Taskbar Settings. And now you're going to see it's going to take me right to this personalization section of my settings within Windows 11. Now, let's go ahead and we're going to see what our options are here. Do I want these things or not? Well, let's go ahead and start off with search. Well, do I want to have the search box, the search icon only, the search icon and the label, or do I want to hide it entirely? You're going to see when I choose that, I get a real-time preview of what that's going to look like. Go ahead and choose that, search icon only, that's great. Or I can come right back to search icon and label, and then go over here to search box, and now I'm back where I started from. Great. The task view. Well, you know what? I actually like to use the keyboard shortcut for that, so I can very easily turn that off or turn it back on if I change my mind. We're going to talk about the keyboard shortcut and how to access the task view in just a little bit. So let's go ahead and turn that off. Now, widgets, some of you may really like, some of you maybe don't want it. So you can very easily turn those off and just notice it goes away. And we can have that come back. I'm going to keep that on for a future lesson. Chat, I'm going to go ahead and turn that off. We're not going to be doing any chat. And that gives me a little bit more room in my taskbar for future icons to work with. Now let's go ahead and come down over here to taskbar behaviors. I click on that, and very simply, I can choose my taskbar alignment. I'm going to go ahead and make that to the left, because I like that. That kind of gives me some nostalgia from how it used to be. That's great. And then do I want to automatically hide the taskbar and then just bring it back when I want it? I can certainly do that. And then badges are basically, if you have different types of notifications, you can have badges show up there like 1, 2, 3 or a little dot. That's going to tell you that there's going to be notifications for you. So there you have it. That's how we customize the taskbar, giving us a little bit more control of how we're going to work with this new operating system. See you in the next lesson.
If you're not a subscriber, click down below to subscribe so you get notified about similar videos we upload. To see the full course that this video came from, click over there. And click over there to see more videos from Simon Says It.